What's up there, good people? You know what time it is. Time for that daily screw. That's right. Time to get the hell out of here for the week. I say for the week because it's the end of mine. Finally, I ain't had a day off in 2 weeks. So I'm glad and happy for my day off. I'm going to go for a little ride. Clear my brain a little bit. Because I stay so busy during the week, keeping everything else that bothers me away, you know, put everything in that little room my daddy taught me. And I asked my dad, you know, Dad, how do you go through life? How do you get through it? You know, without fucking strangling the fuck out of somebody or, you know, shooting yourself. He says, well, he says, I got a little room. I said, what? He says, I got a little room. And he says, I keep it all in. He said, Daddy, I said, it ain't good to, you know, keep everything in. He said, no, son, listen to me. And Daddy said, listen to him. Believe me, you listen to Daddy. He said, I got this little room. He says, with a door on front that's designed by me. It's the strongest door I can possibly ever make in my imagination, in my mind. You know, King Kong and fucking the Hulk and fucking everybody else couldn't break through this son of a bitch. He says, and everything that bothers me, everything that gets under my skin, everybody who irks me, anything that just, he says, I put it behind that door. He says, I chain it up, lock it up. He says, that machete ain't getting out. He said, and then when I take the time, when I'm ready for it, I open that door and I let it all out. You know what I'm saying? He says, I had my big old pity party. Cry if I got to, whatever. He said, then I tell myself, that's enough of that shit. Put it all back in that fucking room. Close that big ass fucking door and ain't nobody getting through. And I guess, you know, he was right because he's made it a long damn time. Before he passed away, you know, 20 years ago. Miss my dad. There's a lot of things that he taught me back then, you know, that just comes to light now. You know, one, like the room, you know. I always remember the room and Baby Bull and Daddy Bull. You know, because my dad was a very big man. He was 250 pounds, bench press 500. Big motherfucker. They all say, what happened to me? I was lazy. Tried to get me into that weightlifting shit. I picked it up. It was heavy. I put it down. Fuck that. But he taught me a lot about everything in life that I really didn't realize what he was teaching me until I came through it. I went through it. And a lot. Talk about strangling the fuck out of somebody. I'm sitting here, as I usually do, early in the morning, trying to finish up, do your daily screw, and get on the fuck out of here. Lo and behold, somebody will come in the door while I'm doing my daily screw. And can see him in the middle of it. Lights are out. But wants to come up here in the middle of it and try to talk to me. Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Goes back to that one word, man. Fucking respect. You know, there's differences between now and the way it used to be. But, you know, I still can't be a hater and hate on them for it, even though I'm aggravated living fucking me. Yes, Daddy. Now listen, Daddy. Fucking a little room. Put that son of a bitch in that fucking room. Squeeze his head between the fucking door. But, you know, can't help it. It's, you know, somebody trying to make a dollar in the wee morning hours. Something they probably shouldn't need to be. You know, I try to help everybody out. If they need a couple of dollars, I try to help them out. You know, And it goes to show, you know, be glad and be happy for what you have. Because me, I'm finishing my day off. I'm getting on my new bike. I'm going home to my home, sleeping in my bed. We had one come up all up in my business real quick. They're happy for the $15 of $100 of shit that they're selling for $15 that they stole. And they're happy with that. I don't know if they're happy with that, but they ain't doing nothing else to fucking make it any better, I guess. You know, so you gotta really count your blessings at times. Because when you think you got it so fucking bad, there's somebody else out there who's got it that much worse. But with that being said, even though somebody may have it worse than what you have, doesn't give them the right to just act an ass or fucking have no respect. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying they gotta have extra respect, but they gotta have fucking common decency of a normal human being. There's so many differences in this world, man. There really is. Like I said, I can sit here and bitch about that and bitch about that, but I get to go home to a home. I ain't gonna be on the street. And you know, there's that fine line there, man. Fucking, we got 1 foot in the fucking penthouse and 1 foot underneath the bridge. And you never know when the tides will turn. So be thankful for what you have. I don't mean give it away or be getting used because you're that thankful, but be thankful for what you have. And, hey, the one that you're trying to help, you know what I'm saying, the one that's, you know, trying to get a couple dollars out of you, make sure that they know that they should be thankful. And you say, well, screw you, thankful for what? Thankful that I don't knock the living crap out of them. One thing I can't stand is no respect. Gets under my skin. But as daddy say, put it back behind that door. You know what I'm saying? Believe me, Scrooge got a big hell of a door, man, in front of his room. Got a big room, man. Got a lot that bothers you. But it's in that room. I'm good. Now, with that being said, I'm gonna close that door and lock it up, put my chains on it, light my torches, go on to the next time. So I'm gonna keep on with the keeping on, people. I'm gonna get my ass on in the house. And I'm gonna holler at y'all good people, manana. Love y'all, people.